मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट क्लास 6 कंप्यूटर साइंस वेयर इन द लास्ट क्लास ऑफ द सेशन वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट सम ऑफ द इंट्रोडक्शन पार्ट रिगार्डिंग द पावर पॉइंट प्रेजेंटेशन, हाउ टू क्रिएट द प्रेजेंटेशन, हाउ टू ओपन द पावर पॉइंट प्रोग्राम इन द कंप्यूटर सिस्टम, ओके, हाउ टू ऐड द डिफरेंट नंबर ऑफ स्लाइड्स एंड व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट components on a PowerPoint window. Clear? So what is power, what is presentation, what is slide pack. Okay, all this we have already discussed. Now we move forward to the chapter, that is viewing and organizing the slide. Here, you have already studied the PowerPoint in class 5th also, where you have learned how to make and how to design the slides. Okay, how to create a PowerPoint presentation. Now, in this chapter, we will learn about the different views. Okay? There are several number of views related to the PowerPoint presentation. Clear? And then, we will learn about how to organize the slides. Like, suppose organizing means, suppose you have created a PowerPoint presentation of 10 to 15 slides are there, and at the last moment you found out that there is some slide or one or two slides are there which are not required within your presentation. So how to remove these slides from your presentation and how to rearrange the sequence of the slides. Suppose if you want to rearrange the slides, if you want to move some slides from last to first or from first to in middle, okay, so you can rearrange the slides also. So this is all what we will learn about viewing and organizing the slides in the this chapter. Clear? Now first of all, viewing the views in a PowerPoint. The PowerPoint provides different types of views which you can view your presentation. The PowerPoint gives you the options or it provides you different types of views. There are different, more than 4 or 5 or 6 different types of views, the options are there, and each one has its own importance. Okay, to access the different views, either you can click on the view tab, either you can directly click on the menu, the view tab, or you can on the status bar also there are different views options are also available there. Okay, so to access to the different views you have two options. Either you can directly go to the view tab, okay, or in the menu or in the ribbon click on the view tab, and from there you can get access to the different views, or you can click on the status bar also. Clear? So some of the views which we will discuss it here is like, first of all, the normal view, then slide sorter view, notes page view, reading view, and outline view. So there are 5 different views, like normal view, slide sorter view, notes page view, reading view, and the outline view. Clear? Along with that, there is a slideshow view option is also there. Clear? So these are the different views. Now, first of all, we will discuss about the normal view. Normal view is generally the default view which is given by the view of the PowerPoint. Whenever you will open the PowerPoint program, the window which appears, or generally the PowerPoint program opens in the normal mode itself. Okay, the PowerPoint opens in a normal view itself. Okay, so by default the view which is available or you are seeing generally is known as normal view. In the normal view, generally allows you that you can add the text or images or videos or sound to your slides. Okay, all type of editing task options are available there in the normal view. Along with that, along with the main slide, along with the that is in the last class we have told you that you can see the main slide on the center. Okay, on the left hand side you will see the slide pan. Okay, so the normal view shows you the main slide, slide pan, note page. Okay, so three things which you will be visible to you on the screen will be on the left hand side, slide pan, on the center, main slide, and on the bottom, just above the status bar, the note page view. The note page is available. Okay, so let's go move and I will show you one by one all the views and I will explain you the importance of these views also. Okay, so let's begin with the normal view. Clear? So the normal view, as I told you, is just a default view. So as soon as we will open a PowerPoint program, by default, the PowerPoint always opens in the normal view itself. Okay? So here I have one slide, one small presentation which I have done. I have with me. Okay? I will show you this and I will explain everything on this particular presentation itself to you. Okay? So this is now. This is the normal view which is available here. Clear? This is the normal view where on the center part you can see. Now this is the normal view. This is the main slide. This is your main slide. This part is known as slide pan. This part is known as slide pan, which has two different tabs are there. One is slide tab and another is in outline tab. Slide tab and the outline tab. And on the bottom of the main slide, you can see there the text is written there. Click to add notes. So this particular part is known as note page. It is known as speaker mode or note page. Okay, so the main working can be done on the main slide or the slide which is present here, and in this you can even add the text, pictures, sounds, or even the videos also. Okay, this is your slide pan. This is your slide pan which shows you all the slides in the thumbnail form. All the slides in the thumbnail forms are visible on the slide pan. Okay, in the miniature form, in the small pictures, it will display you all the slides in a sequential order. When you will click on the outline tab, it will just show you the text which is included in the each slide. It will show you only the text which is included in each slide, and you can easily edit the text from outline tab also. Okay, you can easily edit. Now the third one is speaker mode or the note page, which is the area which is used to add the speaker notes, or the speaker notes are generally the explanatory notes to, like, suppose there is some topic on this particular slide and you want to add some explanatory notes, okay, to explain about more detail about that particular topic, you can write the notes on the speaker note area itself. Okay, so this one is the normal view. Generally it opens in the normal view. Or the another way to get access to the view, different views, as I told you, that either you can click on the view tab or on the status bar itself. can see there are three options are given. Three options are given here. One is normal view, slide shot view, and slide show view. So you can access the different views from here, or you can directly click on the view tab, and from here you can see the first one in the presentation view group, normal view, slide shot view, note page, slide show. Okay. So this is how you can get access to the different view in your presentation. So I hope that the normal view is clear to you. The normal view, this is a default view in a PowerPoint, and in this view you can add the text, images, audios or videos, and it is the main editing view. It is the main editing view which is available in PowerPoint. Okay. The next view which we will discuss here is, before, once again I will tell you what is the use of slide pack, now note page, and the slides. The slide pack generally it displays the thumbnail view of all the slides in a presentation. Okay. Now here you can see, you can scroll down and you can see the total number of view slides here. There are 11 number of slides are there. Now you can see it will display you all the slides. So slide pack, it displays the thumbnail view of all the slides in a presentation, and you can click a thumbnail in a slide pack to view the slide. Due to thumbnail view of all the slides, it becomes easier for you to rearrange, add or delete the slides in a presentation. Like suppose you come to the last slide. Now we are reaching to the last slide, and here I add one more slide. I have added the 12th slide. Okay, I have added the 12th slide. So if you want to remove this slide or you want to delete this slide, what you can do, just you can click on this slide, and on the slide group, on the home tab itself, on the slide group, you will get the delete option. You will get the delete option, and as you can see, the slide has been deleted. Or you can directly right click on this, you can directly right click on this, and you can get the option delete slide. You will get the option delete slide. Other than that, you will get the option of new slide also. Suppose if you want to add a new slide, you can add it here. Or suppose this is the slide and I click on duplicate slide. The duplicate slide option generally creates a duplicate copy or another copy of that particular slide. So now you can see the two slides, the same slide has been created, its copy has been created. So this is how you can duplicate the slide, or you can, another thing, another option that you can do is that you can rearrange the slides. Now what you can do is just click on that particular slide, click on that particular slide, and then you can drag it, you can drag it, and you can just rearrange or move the slides up and down. You can rearrange the order. Okay, you can rearrange the order. Now if you want to delete the slides, what you can do is that just click on that particular slide and click on to delete slide option, this particular slide will be deleted. Slides have been deleted. Clear? Okay. So this is how you can use the slide pack. Another one is note page or sticker note area. Note page or sticker note area. Now you can see this is the note page area, and you can write any explanation.
coding of lift. Okay, now you can see I have just written the explanatory notes. So this is how you can write anything here, and you can add the explanatory notes regarding your project here or your presentation here. So this is the use of home page. The speaker note, the note pane is the present at the bottom of Microsoft PowerPoint display, and this area provides you the space to write speaker notes. The speaker note is the information about. It is generally the information about the particular slides in a presentation. These notes can be helpful to the user while presenting, and you may also create notes for your audience and distribute them in printed form. You can take the printout of note page area also along with the main slide, and you can distribute them, and it will be easier for them to understand the particular topic. Main part is the main slide. The individual page of a presentation form a slide. The different elements that a slide may contain are text, graphic, movies, and the sound. Okay. Now move to the next view. The next view is the slide shorter view. The next view is the slide shorter view, where the slide shorter view enables you to view all the slides on the screen. Now, generally in the normal view, you are only able to view one slide at a time. You are only able to view one slide at a time. But when you are going to use the slide shorter view, when you open it in a slide shorter view, it enables you to view all the slides on the screen in a miniature form, and this facility is helpful in deleting, adding the new slides if required, and rearranging the slides to make the presentation effective. So, in order to access the slide shorter view, you can click on the view tab. You can click on the view tab, and from here you can click on slide shorter. Now you can see the difference between normal view and the slide shorter view. Now all the 11 slides of my presentations are displayed on the screen. All the different 11 slides of my presentations are displayed on a screen, and from here itself, if I want to add a new slide, now you can see the total number of slides has been increased like this. So you can add as many as number of slides you want, or you can drag the slides and you can rearrange the slides. You can rearrange the order. So, now if you want to delete it also, you can click here on the slide and click on delete slide. You can directly delete the slide also from here. So this is how you can view all the 11 slides which we have created is visible on the slide shorter view in the miniature form, in a small form. Okay, and it is basically used to view all the slides together, and if you want to rearrange any slide, just what you have to do, that click on that particular slide and drag it to the new location. Drag and hold your left button of your mouse and drag it to the new location. The slides automatically move to the new location, and in this order
You can rearrange the slides itself. Okay.
Now, as we have completed the slide show thing also. Okay. Now you can directly click on normal view and again you can come back to your presentation. Okay. Next is reading view. Reading view. Generally the reading view. This view, reading view hides the tabs, groups and visual and other elements of the screen and provide a full space to view or read the slide. The reading view generally only display you the main slide on the screen one by one. Each slide will be displayed to you on whole screen
one by one. Okay, I am not going to show you the reading view here because I am using the Office 2007.
I am using Office 2007 and it is not available here. It is similar as a slideshow itself. It is similar to the slideshow itself like this.
It is similar to the slideshow itself and now you can see each and every slide you can view one by one on your monitor screen.
Reading view and you can view the slide on the full screen to read a slide, and generally the reading view hides all the tabs that is above the slide, whatever there are the menus, all the visuals, groups, tabs and all other elements like group page will be hidden to you, slide pan will become hidden to you, status bar, everything will be hidden and it will only open the main slide on your screen in the full screen so that you can easily read the slides. Okay, the next one is outline view. Edit it or you can delete the text, you can delete it from here, you can modify the text or edit the text easily in the outline tab, in the outline tab itself. So this is all for today. Okay, so in this session of the class we have discussed about four different views. One is normal view, then slide shorter view, reading view and the outline view. Okay.
have a very nice day.